In Buffalo, Iowa, police are in pursuit of a stolen garbage truck.
Coming up on another vehicle in front of them.
He's gonna ram him, dude.
Ditch.
I would have expected the truck to drive over the stop sticks or to the right of the stop sticks. He intentionally rammed into Chief Behning's vehicle and in the path where Chief Behning was standing.
A second dash cam captures the moment of impact.
I could see Chief Behning's body twisting in the debris field of the crash. I could see him almost get ran over by the rear tandem wheels of the garbage truck. I didn't know if he had gotten hit by the garbage truck wheels. It looked like he did, but it all happened so quickly, I wasn't sure. I thought he was dead. It was a pretty significant crash.
And he's going into the ditch.
After leading police on a 10-mile chase, the driver, Logan Shoemaker, finally gives up.
Greg, I'm moving up on your right.
I've got you, Greg. Spread out to the right a little bit more, man.
With Shoemaker now in cuffs, officers turn their attention to the injured Chief Behning. His leg has been ripped open from the knee down to his ankle.
My foot is right on his foot. Yep, I got it. Thank you. Cut that sock off. We're gonna do this. Inside. Actually, hold on a second. Ab pack, trauma pack, and we'll get some of this covered up so I get some of the debris out of it.
You all right?
A couple scratches.
TJ, good? Yeah. Still with us?
I'm good.
All right.
Tell me about what happened.
Okay. I opened my car door. I was behind this car about 10 feet getting ready to throw the sticks. And he wasn't making a decision on going right or left. He just came head on at the truck at my car. I had nowhere to go, so at the last minute he moved. He went around me, but my car hit me.
Chief Behning's body cam captures the impact.
I remember putting my hands up to kind of block my face, and that's all. Last thing I remember, just getting hit, and then thinking that I could duck my head so I didn't hit the concrete. But once you get hit with that kind of force, you just are thrown.
Chief Behning's injuries are so severe, he has to be airlifted to the hospital.
As the controlling field supervisor, it's my responsibility to deal with now the aftermath of the crash. So I coordinated the investigation with the Iowa State Patrol, the Scott County Sheriff's Office, and our Criminal Investigation Division. So we were dividing up segments of responsibility on who was going to take care of what. We also had the robbery of the garbage truck that was handled by the Scott County Sheriff's Office, the crash with the Wrangler pickup truck in the city of Bluegrass that they handled, and then the crash there on the highway that the State Patrol handled. So it was my responsibility to make sure that each of the pieces of pie were accounted for.
Little helicopter ride, all good?
TJ,
yeah.
I'm gonna move your other leg over, okay, brother?
All right. I just felt an intense burning in my legs, and I knew they were broke, I assumed they were. But then when I looked down to kind of look at it, I saw my left ankle going the wrong way, and then my pant leg was ripped off, and I reached down, there was a ton of blood, so I knew I was in some trouble there.
One of the responding officers is Greg Behning, Chief Behning's cousin.
Knowing that it's probably TJ's and he's probably hurt, I'm not expecting the level of injury that I ended up seeing.
I was reaching to my left cargo pocket to get my phone, because I knew if I didn't call my wife, I'd be in trouble, so.
TJ had got his phone out of his pants pocket and was trying to dial, and Chief Sikorsky asked him what he was trying to do. He said he was trying to call his wife, at which point the chief took his phone away from him and said to TJ, well, Greg will do that, and handed the phone to me.
I was sitting in my office, and the phone rang. And I even looked at the phone and thought, that's weird, TJ never calls at this time. And I answered it, and it was Greg Behning, his cousin. And he said, Heidi, it's Greg. And I knew by the tone of his voice, I knew it was TJ and I knew it was Ben. And I said, hey, Greg, what's the matter? And he said, it's TJ. He's been in an accident. I don't know what's gonna happen next, but I'm on my way to get you. And I thought, no way. He's on his way to get me because he thinks he's not gonna make it.
Nice and slow up the hill.
I didn't know what his injuries were. I just knew that it was bad because they were airlifting him, so I knew he must have lost a lot of blood. I didn't want to wait. I was afraid that if TJ was going to die, he would die alone.
Chief Behning is airlifted to University of Iowa Hospital to have immediate surgery to save his leg.
When I got to the hospital, it looked exactly like a scene you would see like on TV in a medical drama. I'll never forget the amount of debris that was all over the floor. I mean, there was like ditch weed and there was like parts of the asphalt and his clothing was all cut off of him. There were a lot of hunks of flesh on the ground, around his boot, on the Velcro. I mean, I just remember looking around and thinking, what is under those covers? Like, what is hurt and what is the matter? And he had a C collar around his neck. And so he couldn't see me. And I couldn't make my way to him because there were so many people, so many medical professionals around him. And I'm like, TJ, I just want you to know I'm here. And of course, in TJ fashion, he says, shouldn't you be at work? They said, when they were taking him away, we just want you to know we're gonna do everything we can, but we won't know anything until we get out of surgery. I'm not sure if we're gonna be able to save his leg. And I said, I don't care, just save him.
Surgeons battle for 8 hours to try and save Chief Behning's damaged leg.
TJ didn't get out of surgery until 3:30 in the morning.
When I woke up from surgery, I remember looking down to see if the leg was still there. It was wrapped up and it was still there, so I was happy for that.
21-year-old Logan Shoemaker admits to being on a week-long meth binge prior to the incident. The passenger seen running from the red pickup was later released without further action. Shoemaker is found guilty of attempted murder, eluding police, willful injury causing serious injury, and robbery. He is sentenced to 58 years in prison.
Shoemaker's actions were very reckless. He cared only about one thing, and that was himself. He didn't care who he hurt or what he did to get away. And unfortunately, Chief Behning is paying that price today.
Left tibia was broken, the right fibula was broken. Liz Frank fracture on my left foot. My left toe was kind of torn apart from the rest of them. Main injury on my right, my calf was torn apart, torn off. Physical therapy is just 3 times a week, just go in and trying to rehab the leg. Walking is getting better. I just got rid of a cane probably a month ago or so. So it's getting better, slowly, slowly it's getting better. City of Buffalo has been great, still the chief. The community has been unbelievable. Just go in and do the administrative stuff 3 or 4 hours a day, once a week, just to payroll, stuff like that.
I think he just wants to prove to everybody, I can do this.
It's the only job that I really know and I love, so I definitely want to get back to that.